Oh, awesome. I don't think Gomez will miss this.
Hey!
Oh, hello. I didn't hear you coming. I'm looking for, well, clues about last night's disaster.
I see.
Well, I have to settle this soon. Gomez has little patience, and I have other, more urgent problems to attend to.
What kind of problems do you have that are so urgent?
Well, you see, in the old camp, you can never trust anyone, and even less of those who call you friend. Two of these friends, Cyrus and Bedig, took advantage of the fact that I had to come here to steal from me a very valuable pendant. They know it's important to me, but they would sell their mother in order to get some ore in the black market.
Who are these old friends?
They were more than friends. In fact, they were former business partners. We had our differences, and in the end, we decided to dissolve the business. But I never thought they would dare steal from me.
What does the pendant look like?
You'll recognize it easily. It is made of metal and has the shape of the god Adonis. No incrustations, no jewelry, no magical powers. It doesn't have much value. Clearly, it was stolen out of spite.
Okay, let's be clear. If I help you, what can you give me in return?
A businessman. That's the attitude. I like you. Tell me, what are you looking for, or what do you need? We can start there.
Well, a decent sword would do me good. A weapon that is easy to obtain and has no owner, if you know what I mean.
Oh, I understand. Okay. I won't tell Gomez anything, if you don't tell anyone about our little deal. Okay?
Okay, we agree then. The pendant in exchange for the sword. By the way, where can I find Saris and Beric?
They've gone to the woods, near the bridge, I think. Be very careful. They are violent people. You'd better be prepared for anything. What do you think you're doing, rookie?
Okay, I'm sorry. My mistake. It won't happen again. It's closed. I'll need something to open it.
I'm sorry, Beric. It's the best for everyone. You! Caden sends you to kill me, right? Frickin' bastard!
Come back, coward! No, wait, don't kill me. Let's talk, please. Oh, for Innes. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, boy. Thank you for putting down your sword.
Enough. I'm here to retrieve the pendant you stole from Caden. That's all. What's so funny?
Do you really believe that son of a bitch's story? A pendant we stole from Caden. Look, boy, he sold you a pup.
I don't get it. If you didn't steal anything from him, why did he send me to you?
Caden, Beric and I made a lot of money on the black market thanks to the king's goods until the elevators collapsed. Caden thought there was a partner in excess, and I agreed. And that's why I'm here. Fewer members, more profits. Now I see my ex-partner wants to be the sole owner of the business. That's why you're here. Luckily you didn't kill me, but I hope Caden thinks you did, right? He'll freak out if you tell him the truth.
And you really believe Caden will trust me when I get back? On my word alone. I have no way of proving I killed you.
Yeah, right. And that's a problem. Caden doesn't believe anyone but himself. And he'll trust less on a stranger like you. Okay, we'll do this. I'll give you a gift that Caden gave me years ago as a proof of his friendship. I don't think I'll ever need it again. Caden can get a good price for it. He'll give you whatever you agree with him, and I'll have a second chance away from that son of a bitch. It's a win-win, isn't it?
Wait, what? You mean there's no pendant?
Yes, of course. Although it's not really a pendant. It's rather the key to our business. That's why Beric always kept it hidden.
I need it back. Do you know where he used to keep it?
Oh, shit. I killed him before I asked. In any case, Beric had a very bad memory and used to lose goods before forgetting where he'd temporarily stored them. That's why he wrote everything down in his logbook. It's probably still on his corpse. You can keep it, man. It's all yours. I'm only interested in getting out of this one alive and forgetting all about Caden and his business. I'm done.
You're losing a lot of blood, man. You should tend that wound.
Yeah, you're right. I'll go to the river to clean it. However, I don't think I can survive without any medication or painkiller. But I don't have the strength or energy to look for it.
All right, I'll see what I can do.
I know I'm not in a position to ask you any favour, but if you help me, I'll be able to escape to the new camp where Caden won't find me. And in the future, I'll be able to return the favour. All right. I'll take care of it. I'll wait for you on the riverbank. And please don't be late. I need those medicines fast, or I don't think I'll get out of it.